As the saying goes, loud pipes save lives. The Combat Veterans Motorcycle Association is helping its community and those who have served this country 1 mile at a time. We're happy to be joined by Eddie Freight Train Negron, chapter commander for the Combat Veterans Motorcycle Association, and Alex Scrubs Brown, the organization's executive officer. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on this Veterans Day.
Well, thank you for having us.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
First and foremost, Master Sergeant Eddie, can you tell us a little bit more about this association and how it got formed?
Sure. So the Combat Veterans Motorcycle Association is an association of combat veterans from all five branches of the United States Armed Forces who ride motorcycles as a hobby. Our main mission is to support other veterans, especially those who defended our country and our freedoms. We focus on veteran organizations, homeless veterans, care facilities, providing meals, clothing, shelter. But the Combat Veterans Motorcycle Association started in 2001 back in Missouri with just a handful of veterans, and then continued to grow. We're now in all 50 states as well as Europe and Asia.
Oh, goodness. I think I did see that on your website. You do have people from all over the world who are joining in this association for the betterment of their brothers and sisters in uniform. And Alex, you are a second lieutenant in the Army. First of all, gentlemen, I want to say thank you for your service and thank you for continuing your service by helping other veterans. Maybe you can tell me a little bit more about your service, Alex.
Sure, yes, ma'am. I started my career in the Army kind of as a late guy, as a 26-year-old, but joined in 2012 and started with a career in active duty, serving a little over 3.5 years, and then transitioned into the National Guard, where I continue to pursue higher education, working towards a nursing degree, which led me to my recent commissioning back in January into the Nurse Corps for the South Carolina Army National Guard, and then where I continue to serve now.
I see. And Eddie, you served 25 years in the military. I want to know where your passion for motorcycles came from.
It just came really for just something different to do. Most veterans, we tend to be a little bit of adrenaline junkies after, you know, being such a high tempo pace, you know, always on the edge, I would want to say, just based it's the nature of the beast. And so sometimes we want to find something where we can ride and just kind of either get that adrenaline rush or just be able to just focus on one thing. You know, sometimes just that distraction of riding a motorcycle, you have to concentrate when you're riding. So it takes your mind off everything else that you may be thinking about. So for me, I mean, it's a means of relaxation. Plus, I got to meet a bunch of other brothers and sisters who ride as well, who have the same goal and passion as I do, is helping other veterans.
Tell us how we can help your association. How is it that the community around your veterans, our veterans, can help further your programs and assist in life after the military?
So other than the obvious, as far as, you know, financial assistance, there's other things. One is just identifying veterans that are in need. We have a program within our chapter that we provide funds for any veterans that may be struggling financially. We assist them like with utility bills and rent, and other items like that. As far as just recently, there's a Vietnam veteran that reached out to us because he was robbed and needed a new bed. He had bed bugs, and so the money that he had saved up for his new bed was robbed. He was robbed, and so we assisted with replacing his bed and mattress. But I think the key thing for us is identifying those veterans that are in need. We also do drives as far as we collect items for the Veterans Victory House, 180 Place, also Patriots Villas, and there's Kenwood Apartments. Those are all places where veterans reside that are either homeless or are transitioning from homelessness. And so they may not have everything that they need. And so we collect a lot of just personal care items, clothing, food, and we distribute it to those locations as well and assist those veterans that are in need there.
That's wonderful. And for you, Lieutenant Alex, maybe you can tell us just quickly what you hope to see for the future of military veterans out there. I know that it's becoming more and more important for us to really show our support and appreciation for all that you do for us. So what do you hope to see in the future?
I think it's a good thing to look towards, again, kind of like what Eddie said, identifying veterans. And hoping especially to help those in need to find adequate housing. And we have some local opportunities in the community that are helping do that. But recognizing that a lot of veterans come from disenfranchised places, they enter into service and they're given a lot of their day-to-day activities provided for them. And that transition out of service where they don't have that support network and ability to have a brother or sister to lean on, they lose a lot of that network. And our association works, not only provide that for our brothers and sisters within the association, but that outreach to help other veterans in need. And so really just identifying other brothers and sisters that are hurting in the community and need assistance. That's a thing that we have to continue to work on because we continue to get more and more veterans.
It's incumbent upon us to rally around our veterans and to help support them in life after they've hung up their uniforms. Gentlemen, I want to thank you so much for joining us and thank you for all that you do for our community.
Thank you for having us again.
Thank you so much. Yeah, absolutely.
We return after this.